Hello and welcome to another plant video. So today I thought I'll do something interesting, which is to rank my top seven favorite house plants from my collection. So I thought it'd be an interesting one. I have seen a lot of these kind of top favorite plant videos of so many other YouTubers in the house plant community, and I love watching them. I love knowing the reasons why people like certain plants and how they rank them. And I thought, let me try and do that. And it was so difficult, but I am ranking my top seven plants today, and all of them are my favorites, but there are different reasons of why they stand on a different number. So let's get into it. Okay, so starting very quickly with this, I have plant number seven, which is my seventh on the top favorite list, and this is my Syntapsis pictus exotica. So I have placed this plant on number seven because amongst the other six plants, of course, this one has had a specific journey. It gave me a bit of a trouble, to be honest, and it took so long to become how bushy it is right now. So if you can see, it's not, of course, like that big and bushy as I had aimed for it to be. I had put a goal with this plant when I got it first, and I think I ordered two of these, if I'm not wrong, or I think I ordered two of these from a kind of a renowned seller online, and one of them did okay. The other one, I tried to propagate it. It didn't really work well, but there is a cutting as well of that here. In between, I realized one of the vines was not really connected in the soil, in the root, and it was dying out completely, which is propagating in water behind at the shelf. But yeah, easy to propagate for sure. I've always got good roots. I have had two, three propagations of it in perlite, which all did very well. The lovely part about this plant is, of course, the patterns, the silvery splashes, even the size of the leaves. I think because I have one more Syntapsis silver splash, which is not like having these kind of big leaves. So really happy with this. Did well. Could have been, of course, longer, but I thought I'll also document this plant today, alongside putting it on the top seven list, so that in the future I know where it stands. So yeah, that's plant number seven. In terms of care for this, I really don't do nothing, and maybe that's why it is in the favorites list at all, because I just keep it there. It's a trailing version. You can try and make them climb as well, or put a trellis, or really have really nice, it attaches to the wall with those clips, which I haven't tried. Could be an interesting thing to do. But mine is just plain and simple trailing, which I wanted. And I have a goal of having a much bigger, bushier version of this. And yeah, in terms of care, it gets less light. A grow light, of course, which is back on the shelf there. It gets very less light. It unfortunately gets a lot of wind from the fan above the dining table there, so it's always a bit dried up. In fact, this seems to be a bit thirsty. You can see the leaves are curling up, they're a bit limp. So I think I can, no, not yet. Also, I think it has water, but maybe then it's the fan which has caused the leaves to curl up, because it gets a bit dry there. It is in 50% humidity. But yeah, lovely plant, a must have in any houseplant collection. So that's plant number seven. Okay, so getting into plant number six, again a Syntapsis, and again a trailing hanging plant. This is my Syntapsis tribui moonlight. I love it, love it, love it. I think I should have cleaned the leaves before I got it on in front of the camera, but I think it is doing amazing. It's one plant I think I thought was going to be so difficult, but it actually turned out to be very easy. I was very afraid of it because it is one of the rarer versions of Syntapsis, and I had heard so much about it and read the kind of instructions. The care guide seemed tough to me for some reason, because getting the right amount of light is very important. Otherwise, the silvery color, the bluish silvery tone the leaves has will not really continue. It changes that. So I think I managed to find the right spot for it, which is again in the cabinet there in the center, where it's a bit covered from those Tibetan prayer flags, and that kind of dapples the light because it likes dappled low indirect light. And Even this plant, I have never done anything special to take care of it. In fact, it had mealy bugs when I got it, and it took a couple of weeks or a couple of months actually for me to, I think there's maybe one or two things still left, but yeah, it is maybe prone to mealy bugs then. So you can see the little white thing here. I think that's that, but I just use a neem oil solution. That's the only care I did for a couple of weeks, the starting maybe 1.5-2 months, and that was enough. All of this is kind of the new growth, which is fine. I'm not happy with the size of it, but I don't blame it because I'm not trying to grow the leaf sizes. I'm just happy maintaining the leaves which it came with, which are pretty tall, long actually. So really good size. I love this whole very futuristic silver bluish tinge the leaf colors have. I just love that so much. A definite standout, and actually looks very good. It's actually, though the new growth has not been so much, but it has maintained itself. So these are actually those house plants, the low light house plants, which you can maintain very easily. Again, a definite recommendation. This plant a while back was not so easily accessible is what I had noticed. So I took it the first chance I got it on a group. I took it, I went for it, I bought it, and I got a good big version. Right now a lot of people sell it, but they're typically selling a single vine only, so watch out for that. Just go for a bushy trailing plant always. Go for a bushy version is what I would say. And yeah, really nice, very ornamental, again needs water. I have to get on top of that. Before I get into the next plant, which would be plant number 5, I think I need a sip of my tea. I just came back from office, and before the light goes out, I love shooting in this natural light, which is coming from the window right behind this cam, my phone. I love shooting in that because that's the most natural, that shows the most natural colors of the leaves, and it's going out pretty fast, so I have to wrap this up very, very soon now. So I'm going to get into plant number 5, and the reason this is on 5 and above Syndapsis trivium moonlight, the previous one, is because I'm finally seeing some growth on it after nothing. So this is Hoya Wilbur Graves, and I love it, love the colors on this one. And this leaf which you see, this is what this is special for, like all of the leaves actually, just like not this one but all of them, the kind of splashes, very silvery, very minty, different patterns, all kinds of splashes. I love it so much. And this entire vine is a new growth, and this is very important. I was actually reading about this yesterday. I was seeing a lot of videos about vines on Hoyas and should we cut them, and we shouldn't, because the blooms actually come as part of these vines, the peduncles come as part of these vines. So it's a good sign that this plant is showing this, which by the way is rooting currently in perlite and very well. Actually it's rooting quite well, so a lot of new roots. Hoyas have thin and shorter roots, so to be able to see them actually so much is good, which means it's doing very well. And of course the sign is this entire peduncle, which grows by an inch every day in fact, and the greenhouse cabinet is instrumental in that, because before that this plant was there with me for months. It had nothing at all. I think I would have just killed this plant because I didn't know how to water it, but putting it in perlite and in the cabinet makes it so easy for me, because the water remains in the perlite. I don't have to frequently check the water of the perlite because the humidity, this was an 81% humidity right now when I removed it, so I don't have to worry about watering it at all. And yeah, hoping very soon for a bloom. I don't know if that's gonna be a peduncle or something here at the tip, but yeah, I ordered this actually from Amazon, which is quite a surprise because no one seemed to have Hoya Wilbur Graves. I'd been asking all the sellers but they didn't have it, and I really wanted it, so I took a chance because Amazon plants at times have been good. My black velvet was from there, from Little Jungle. This is from some other seller which I don't know the name of, but I'm so happy. This was the only piece left. Totally recommend it. If you want Hoyas, you like Hoyas, do get Wilbur Graves. there's so much background information about it, there's so much controversy about it, and I've done a video on that. So it would be great that, you know, it's a plant with history and story in it. So yeah, go for it is what I would say. Love it for the way it's growing suddenly, and that's my plant number 5. Also, I'm keeping this in this IKEA pot, so I really love the look of this pastel pink with these minty green silvery splashy leaves. Looks really good, adds a really nice pastel color in my greenhouse cabinet too, so that's a pretty neat combo. Love it, very cute. Just a second. Plant number 4, and we're getting closer to the top 3, but plant number 4 is very special. Super jungle foresty vibes. I love the way it is, not an organized looking kind of a plant. It's very unruly, and the minute I use the word unruly, this plant comes to my head all the time. Anyone uses that word, it's basically this big huge, let's see if you guys can guess it. But that's my philodendron Perezo verde. And this has gotten huge. It is lovely. Wait, let me just get into the other camera mode so you can see it better. I think I need to buy a good camera now. I can't be shooting on the phone anymore. But look at this plant. I just love it. I can't believe it looks so nice on the camera actually. This is so huge now. This is exactly, I think, what all of us love about having house plants, the way they just grow so tremendously, enormously. This is the newest leaf. It is still hardening up. So the colors on a Perezo verde is its most unique striking feature. It depends highly on the amount of light it gets, the temperature it is kept in, so very critical, and hence I have kept it right here next to the window because I want the nice warm temperature. Like, it's not hot at all, it's nice and warm because the AC runs here and it's a northeast facing window, so there's no direct sun ever on this, so it just gets a nice warm light, indirect light, for a couple of hours in the day, and then once the sun is above the building in which we stay, then it's just ambient lighting. So it's in room conditions, it has never been in the cabinet. It has two shoots, one isn't doing so well. So this one isn't doing so well. This one is doing fine. I don't know why this is not doing well, but it's growing a lot of aerial roots, so I don't want to check. I don't want to do anything. I'll just let it be. Like, this leaf isn't unfurling, and I think it has maybe spider bites or something. Like, this is the newest leaf, but it won't unfurl. But the new one is coming. But I do think I need to give it a basic TLC one of these days, because I think it could have spider mites. It had them before, but I didn't do anything about it. I just sprayed it with my spider mites homemade solution. But love this plant so much, and it's at number 4. This look that you see from the back side, of course, that's the other side. It faces the window like this. It faces, this is the outside facing side, that's why all the leaves are there. And I end up seeing this side from my living room, which I actually like. I like this whole, you know, spread out kind of a big, huge plant look. So yeah, love it. That's why this is on number 4. Just a note on the Perezo verde, I had put this in a self-watering pot, and I've done a whole video on Perezo verde and so many features about this plant and a lot of details, but that self-watering pot didn't really work. And this pot, the clay one, I had my Anthurium crystallinum in it, which is a wrong combination with the kind of soil, and the clay pots dry out too soon. So even now this dries up too soon, so I wouldn't recommend putting it in a clay pot with the chunky soil mix because it just dries up too soon. So I have to keep up with the watering on this plant, but right now it's still happy. Like, one of the shoots is happy, the other one, I'm just, like I said, I'm gonna let it be. But wanted to add that note, avoid clay pots, I would say, unless you want to use it as a cover pot. I have potted it directly, but cover pot usage would have been better. So here's plant number 3. We're in the top 3 now. This is my Anthurium Pap crossed with Raven's Heart. Raven's Heart also, I think, is a cross of AOS and a Pap. I think that's what it is. But this leaf right now is the newest leaf. I'm also showing the backside of it, and I know you can't see it, but it's still kind of holding on to its emergent colors. And I will insert some clips of this one because I have so many. This is the newest leaf. It's very, very velvety. It was almost like a copper red color, and this is still growing. It will become way bigger, I'm sure, to harden up. This is the last leaf which is hardened up here now. I think I'm losing the light for my top few plants left for today, so maybe I'll have to shift this setup. But nevertheless, this is my Anthurium hybrid, PAP hybrid, and it looks amazing. This is the oldest leaf right now, which is very, very thick, very shiny. It's got a very dark color, which is what people love about PAPs, I believe. And you can have a look at the venation, really nice veins. Let me show it from the back camera. Yeah, that's kind of now showing the colors, the emergent colors I was talking about, which was earlier pure copper red, but right now it looks good too. Look at the colors of this one and this one, and look at the stem. The plant stem itself is red, which is where the new leaf will come from soon. So this is my top three right now, at number three, because I purely just love the emergent colors and the way it grows. The speed at which this plant is growing is just amazing, and this leaf is just immaculate. It's perfect, not a single sign of stress or damage on it. So that's my plant number three for now. Okay, so very quickly now, plant number two. We're on the top two right now, and I'm losing light outside, and I don't know how nicely you'll be able to see it, but this is my Philodendron Tautum. It is a beauty. The fact of the new leaves, the way the new leaf comes, and again I will try and insert some footages of when this leaf was unfurling, which it is even now. It is crazy. The way the leaves unfurl is just another level. Must have plant. I've heard some people have a tough time because of humidity issues, I think, because the way this unfurls, it needs a good amount of humidity. This is in right now 81% of humidity, and I love this. I have done an unboxing of this plant, and I won't get into much of details right now. You can see that video as well. But really good specimen, I would say, since the time I've got it. I think, yeah, this one was the newest leaf that time, which was unfurling, something like this one, and it looks so pretty. Love this whole skeletal structure. That's what this plant is popular for, this whole skeletal look of the leaves which is there, and of course the way the new leaves come. Again, let me try and show it from the back. Yeah, so here you go, much better look. The new leaves are, of course, they have a brownish copperish green color, and they look lovely. Must have. These plants love to be on a stake or a moss pole, but I'm going to put mine on a stake, which is what I've seen most people do. Just look at this. Look at the way the parts of the leaves are all curled up, and the way they open up. The way this was looking yesterday was amazing. I will try and include some clips. No wonder this is on number two. It almost fought for number one spot, but number two is fine as well. Love it, love it, love it. Okay, very, very quickly getting into the top plant, and any guesses, please do leave a comment at this point before I reveal what it is, if you can guess what this plant is. I have been dying to show this leaf now. I have been, of course, showing it on my Instagram stories and shorts and everything, and I've been covering its journey, but now it's about mature and I've been dying to show it. This is my Anthurium crystallinum, and look at the size of this leaf. It is the most beautiful leaf ever. Great specimen, perfect leaf, perfectly immaculate leaf, not a single sign of any stress or any issues, and I'm so grateful. Oops, this is not on noise cancellation, but now it is. But okay, so my storage got over. But I think saying that I've managed to not cause harm to this leaf, and it's perfectly perfect, immaculate, beautiful, not a sign of any distress on it. And look at that shine. Let me show it from the back camera very quickly. So here it is. Look at the shine. How thick it is, how big it is, how velvety it is. I'm actually finally touching it today, and I've already put some dust on it. So I have barely any space left to record anymore, so I'm gonna wrap it up here. But this is plant number one, my top favorite plant right now. I think I was talking about the pot extender, which is working really well. I think because of that, this leaf has grown up to be what it is today. So yep, that's about it. So that is it for today. This is plant number one. I am wrapping it up. Sorry about this rushed ending, but there is no storage on my phone and the light is almost out, and I think the plants deserve to be shown in much better lighting. So I'll wrap this up here, but I'm so happy to be recording this because I was so excited the whole day. I wanted to come home and record this video for you guys, and of course to document the journey of the plants. So thank you so much. If you watch this, do subscribe to the channel, like the video, and I will see you next time. Bye.